If you are a university student, you may remember the thrill of attending homecoming and Halloween parties with your friends, or going out for a night of fun. Of course, this was before the arrival of a global pandemic that disrupted many of our social lives as we know it. You may recall in your distant memory that alcohol was a common denominator at many of these university gatherings. In fact, you may have experienced the effects of alcohol consumption, such as feeling intoxicated, breaking the seal, and hangover. Well, in today's video, we're going to take a more specific look at how alcohol exhibits these effects on the body. So what actually happens when alcohol enters your body? Let's begin by taking a look at the molecule that we are actually referencing when we use the term alcohol. The active ingredient within alcoholic beverages that induces its effects is known as ethanol. Ethanol is a small organic compound with a chemical formula C2H5OH. So how does ethanol move through the body? There are two steps in this process: absorption and distribution. These processes involve the passage of a substance from the site of administration into the bloodstream for delivery to the body's fluids and tissues. Most absorption of ethanol occurs within the small intestine. However, small amounts may be absorbed in the mouth, stomach, and large intestine as well. The amount of alcohol absorbed contributes to an individual's blood alcohol concentration, also known as BAC. There are many other factors that affect blood alcohol concentration, including body weight, gender, speed of alcohol consumption, and whether alcohol is consumed with or without food. Females and individuals with lower body weight typically develop higher blood alcohol concentrations more quickly because they have less body water. Additionally, drinking on an empty stomach leads to faster absorption and therefore higher blood alcohol concentration. Eventually, ethanol makes its way into the hepatic portal vein and reaches the liver, where most alcohol breakdown, also known as metabolism, occurs. Metabolism is often assisted by enzymes, proteins that speed up the rate of chemical reactions. In this case, two main enzymes assist with alcohol metabolism: ADH, which is alcohol dehydrogenase, and ALDH, which is aldehyde dehydrogenase. There are three steps involved in alcohol metabolism. In the first step, ethanol is converted to a molecule known as aldehyde by the enzyme alcohol dehydrogenase. Next, the aldehyde is converted to a molecule known as acetate by the enzyme aldehyde dehydrogenase. Much of this acetate leaves the liver and travels to other tissues, where it is activated to acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA is a molecule that is produced from all the major nutrients that are consumed by humans, including carbohydrates, fat, and excess protein. Therefore, the breakdown of alcohol eventually produces the same products as the food we eat. So how is alcohol excreted from the body? Most of the ethanol a person consumes, about 95 to 98%, is removed from the body through this process of metabolism, and less than 10% is eliminated by excretion via the lungs, kidneys, and skin.
Have you ever felt happy after a few drinks? This may be due to alcohol causing us to feel a certain way. Alcohol affects our neurotransmitter and helps send messages from our brain to the rest of our body. Essentially, neurotransmitters are synonymous to signals that the brain uses as communication to the rest of our body. One signal we will look at today is dopamine. Dopamine is a neurotransmitter that is regulated by the mesolimbic pathway. The mesolimbic pathway is a connection in our brain that generates pleasure and reward. Dopamine produces a feeling of pleasure in addition to how we think and prepare. As a result, alcohol has a tendency to activate the areas that release dopamine in the human brain, leading to higher levels. However, it is seen that after a few drinks of alcohol, our brain tends to produce more dopamine than usual. However, those that quit drinking after may suffer withdrawals to feeling happy since alcohol was their source of dopamine production. This is due to because alcohol over a time span may cause dopamine levels to drop and lead to alcohol addiction. In addition, the drop in dopamine levels after drinking for a while is due to alcohol causing our brain to release dopamine more than it can produce when we are intoxicated. Coupled with the other effects that alcohol plays in our body, such as hangovers and peeing often, alcohol has a huge effect on our brain, All in all, dopamine is a neurotransmitter that affects our mood and is negatively affected by alcohol intoxication.
Have you ever noticed extremely long lines for the bathroom at a party? Or the increased feeling that you have to pee when you drink? Or maybe someone has told you not to break the seal when drinking? Well, it turns out that there is a biological basis for increased urination when you drink, and it has nothing to do with the volume of liquid consumed. In your body, you have a hormone called antidiuretic hormone, or ADH. ADH, which is also known as vasopressin, is made in a part of the brain called the hypothalamus, and is stored and released from a structure known as the posterior pituitary, which is also located in the brain. ADH is responsible for maintaining and conserving the amount of fluid in the body. It does this by controlling how much fluid is excreted in urine. To simplify, ADH regulates the amount of urine produced by your body. ADH does this by communicating with the kidneys, where urine is produced, to reabsorb water from the urine. By reabsorbing water, more is retained within the body, preventing dehydration. Alcohol is a diuretic, which means that it inhibits the secretion of ADH into the blood, and it increases the amount of fluid excreted. With less ADH circulating in the blood, the kidneys are unable to reabsorb water back into the body. With decreased ADH, the urine that the kidney creates is very diluted. The body is excreting more water than it should, and this results in increased urination. When you drink alcohol, you are urinating more than you would if you drank the same volume of another fluid, like water. Increased urination can lead to dehydration, as the body is not absorbing fluids back into the blood and tissues. Have you ever woken up after a night of drinking with a terrible headache? Perhaps you have suffered from what people might call a hangover. Well, some symptoms of the dreaded hangover may be caused in part by the dehydration as a result from ADH suppression in the blood. Symptoms of dehydration include feeling dizzy or lightheaded, feeling tired, headache, and nausea. These are also common symptoms associated with a hangover. While dehydration is not the only factor that can cause unpleasant feelings after a night of drinking, it can definitely be a major cause if the body is not rehydrated. While there is no cure for these symptoms, over-the-counter pain relief such as ibuprofen or Advil and the intake of a lot of fluids can help alleviate symptoms from dehydration. While drinking can be fun, it is always important to drink in moderation and put your health first. If you or anyone you know is struggling from alcohol abuse, there are ways to get help. Use any of the resources here to find help for yourself, a family member, or a friend. We hope you have enjoyed our video about the signs behind drinking alcohol. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to the Demystifying Medicine channel for more informational videos about science and medicine. Cheers!